guess she was going to be.
Do 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 we're both afraid to say we're just too far away from being close together from the stars.
Welcome, everyone. I need all the graduates to be seated. Thank you.
Where's my, Eileen, I need that book. Good morning, everyone. My name is James Byers. I am chair of elementary and early childhood education. Please silence all cell phones. I would like to officially call to order the Department of Elementary and Early Childhood Education's May 2015 Department Commencement Ceremony. Good morning, everyone. We have many esteemed guests and colleagues here, and I would like to welcome to all of the families, friends, and in particular the graduating class, the Department of Elementary and Early Childhood Education's May 2015 Commencement Ceremony. I would like to also welcome Dean Jeff Pass, Vice Provost Aiva Zaki, and our colleagues in the department. I would like to introduce them one by one. Dr. Anthony Conti, Dr. Blythe Heinitz, Dr. Jody Eberly, Dr. Karen Prince, Dr. Louise Amentort, Dr. Stuart Carroll, Dr. Tim Hornberger, Professor Linda Burrows, and on this side, Dr. Tabitha Delangelo. And let's give a very special thank you to Dr. Lauren Madden. She was the faculty speaker at yesterday's commencement ceremony, and she gave a wonderful speech to everyone, and if you weren't there, you can find it online. Professor Eileen Hetty, Dean Jeff Pass, Vice Provost Aiva Zaki, and our colleague, Dr. Steve O'Brien in Tech Studies. I would also like to take a moment to extend a hearty thank you to Mr. Corey Drake. He's walking around in a gray suit. He's one who's been very helpful in getting everyone arranged. Our office manager, Thomasine Preston, and Dr. Tabitha Delangelo for their tireless efforts and support behind the scenes in planning this wonderful event. Let's give them a round of applause. So in preparing for this culminating celebration of our students' achievements for both undergraduates and graduates, I went through several phases in preparing this commencement address. I have the final three versions of my address written here. The first one simply says, "Say something inspirational." And the second one is probably a little bit too much. It's a little too verbose. So I looked to the Goldilocks principle for guidance and decided on this one, which is hopefully going to be just right. So I've considered many themes, words of wisdom, platitudes, and other ways to inspire you and convey our pride. in you when reflecting on what each of you has accomplished up to this point. This was no easy task, as there are innumerable successes, experiences, and accomplishments to draw upon. Therefore, I decided to explore the themes of paths, journeys, and goals. Each of us has chosen a path which is leading us on a journey to attain our goals, with a primary goal for each of you to become a teacher. And in thinking back on my path, I can attribute a great number of my professional and personal choices to the influences of many teachers I've had over the years. In particular, I recall one of my high school algebra teachers, Mr. John Brown, who trusted in me, whether wisely or not, to trade places with him for a day. On teacher-student swap day, I was permitted to teach lessons on the division of rational polynomial expressions to my classmates, a divisive lesson in the second semester algebra course. This content is complicated and can represent a cognitively challenging topic for many students. In supporting my aspirations to become a teacher and helping me to experience the joys and challenges of teaching math, Mr. Brown was a significant factor in my decision to become a teacher of mathematics and beginning the long path and exhilarating journey to reach my goal of becoming a teacher. I am supremely grateful for his influence toward that end. 25 or so years later, Mr. Brown and I are friends on Facebook. What a lasting impact he has had on me. And although I don't need to see all of the pictures of his new fire engine red convertible Mustang, it's still nice to stay in touch. Who knows where my journey would have taken me if Mr. Brown didn't offer such direction on my path so many years ago. I am certain that each of you has crossed paths with a teacher in your life's journey who has had a similar impact on you. Perhaps she offered that moment of encouragement when you were struggling, or she helped you figure out that hard math problem, or he inspired you to take your writing to the next level and really put yourself out there, or maybe they just gave you a hug. The path you are on today can likely be traced back to one of your teachers, and now your path is taking on a direction to where you will be in a position to inspire your children. As a teacher, advisor, and department chair, I have had the pleasure of working with many of you in multiple capacities. I think back to when you first arrived here at the college, and I recall the many bright young minds and eager students who were so ready to start a new path here and begin your journeys toward becoming teachers. You have each demonstrated excellence in your courses, persevering through the many challenges that you have faced as teacher candidates. You have spent countless hours composing papers, studying for exams, preparing lessons for your field placement classes and student teaching. You have conducted research, written papers for publication, presented your work at conferences, all of which has taken you further along your path to this moment, this event, this part in your journey toward becoming a teacher. You have experienced methods courses where you learn to prepare and execute individual lessons. You have survived ACB and Internship 1 and prepared and taught units. You thrived in student teaching where you began to experience the daily challenges and rewards of being in the classroom on the front lines with your students. You experienced that little extra level of intimidation / professionalism if you had the good fortune to work with Dr. Conti. You witnessed the sheer pleasure that Dr. Tim gets from working with so many of you while sporting his Amish overalls and riding his Amish scooter. And if you were in one of my classes, you've heard the occasional bingo blammo or awesome possum exclamation of affirmation. In any case, you have been part of this department for some time now, and as prospective teachers, the path that each of you is on has taken you to this juncture. You've experienced our commitment to you as our students, and now it is your turn to show that your children that same kind of commitment. Although your journey as a prospective teacher is ending, your journeys to becoming the kind of teacher your children will need has only just begun. The faculty in this department cannot be more proud of you and what you have done to get to this point. You are achieving one of your primary life goals of becoming a teacher. However, you need to begin the next part of your journey in becoming the kind of teacher you want to be, the kind you need to be for your children. Teachers face many challenges on many fronts. Parents and guardians will want to know what you're going to do to help their child. Administrators will want to know how you are going to help your students advance to the next level. They will also want to know what you will do to make their test scores go up. But most importantly, your students will turn to you daily for that immeasurable added support, and they will need you to recognize how special they are. Although helping them to achieve the good grade, advancing to the next level, and getting the high test scores are all important, there are so many other important things that being a teacher is all about. So many intangible qualities that have an effect on students, the impact of which is not so easily quantified in a good grade or a high test score. Albert Einstein said it so well, "Not everything that can be counted counts, and not everything that counts can be counted." I assure you, though, that everything you do from this day forth as a teacher counts. I urge you to remember that although you will face many difficulties and challenges as a teacher, you will need to find your balance. Look to the Goldilocks principle to find what is just right for you and for your children. Push them to achieve academically. But don't forget to give them that additional affirmation. Find your inner bingo blammo. Like it says on our department website, teaching is not just a profession, but also a passion. Don't let go of the passion that has driven you to this point. Become the teacher you have always wanted to be and the teacher your children will need you to be. You have accomplished so many incredible things here at TCNJ and in this department, in everything you have done to get to this point. We have done our job in preparing you to begin the next phase of your journey. We have supported you in developing the tools you will need to help you become the teacher your children will speak of so fondly. Mr. Brown may not have known at the time, but he ignited in me a fire which lit the way for me to follow my path. I now pass that baton to each of you. It is your job now to do everything you can to help your children, inspire them, encourage them, give them that little extra push when they need it, or just a hug. Ignite the passion in them. I would like to leave you with these parting words. Our world is growing and expanding. Our societies are both local and global. Our children will become the arbiters of not only theirs, but also our futures. And as teachers, we are responsible for guiding them, finding their paths, sharing in their journeys, and achieving their goals, as really these together comprise the singular goal we all share, to be the best that we can for ourselves and each other. So when you are done here today, you don't need to go out and immediately write a lesson plan or design a formative assessment, but you should understand that you are now indoctrinated fully into the teaching profession. And although you are no longer a student in this department, you are a student of life. And as such, must continue to learn and grow, to continue toward being everything that you need to be for your children. You will be leaving this commencement as esteemed graduates. As such, we can drop the prospective aspect. We are all very proud to now call you our colleagues. Congratulations to all of you, the Department of Elementary and Early Childhood Education Class of 2015. I would like now to introduce Dean Jeff Pass to share a few words with you. Thank you.
Good job. Thank you. Good morning. I can't help but think as I was walking over here this morning about my own commencement many years ago and how I set out to become the very, very best teacher, as I'm sure most of you are thinking the same way. And I thought back to my beginning year as a fourth grade teacher, and I was, really working hard, really trying to make these students learn, and I kept running up against obstacles. Obstacles because there were areas of policy that I had no control over. I didn't determine the curriculum. I didn't determine what textbooks we used. I didn't determine the special education services that were provided in my school. I didn't determine whether there was a school counselor. I didn't control the social welfare agencies that were needed to serve my students. And I realized that you can't just be a good teacher in a classroom, although you need to be, because nobody really cares what you think if you're not a really good teacher in the classroom, but you've got to do more. You've got to influence the policies that control what it is you and your students get to do. You could be the best instructor in the world, but if you're teaching curriculum that is inappropriate for your students, it doesn't really matter how good you are. And you could be the best classroom manager in the world, But if the school policies regarding misbehavior go against what best practices suggest, you're going to be frustrated. So what do we do about that? What we do is what you've been trained to do here. Use theory, use research, and express your articulate opinions to policymakers and explain to them what's going on. Because they think they know what's going on because they've been to school. Or they have children who have gone to school. And they don't really know unless we tell them. Now, you may not be the kind of individual that speaks to power. I could understand that. But you don't have to be the person. You could support the people who are doing that work. And what I'm talking about is joining professional organizations, whether it's in your content area, such as math or social studies or reading, or perhaps it's a general organization of teachers. Join the organization, support its goals, make sure that arguments are being made to the people who are determining the policies that control your lives and your students' lives so that you can do the best job you can and you have the support that you need to do it. Otherwise, you're going to be frustrated. But if you can make those points, if you can convince people to get good policies in place, whether at the grade level or the school level or the school system level or even in the county, you will be making a profound difference. And thus, I want to leave you with these three words: make a difference. Thank you.
Thank you, Dean Pass. I would like now to take a moment to introduce our next speaker. Kevin Mount is an elementary education math major, part of the graduating class of 2015. He was selected by all of you for this honor. I would like to now introduce Kevin Mount to speak on your behalf.
Good morning. Good morning, family, friends, faculty, administrators, and fellow graduates. I would like to thank my fellow classmates for nominating me for this honor. There is no better feeling than being in a room full of professionals that are about to change the world. The education professors often tell us how principals separate resumes. They make the TCNJ pile, then they make the everybody else pile. I don't blame them. I would like to show you with a story. In my sophomore year, I was placed in an urban bilingual school for my first ever practicum. I was in a third grade classroom, observing lessons and assisting children with their work. There was one child in particular my cooperating teacher warned me about. He sat in the back of the classroom in seclusion, mostly with his head down. He was the trouble kid. One day, I went up to the desk to help him, and I noticed he was making a paper airplane. I asked him to put it away, but I was ignored. So I took it with the provision that if he did his work, I would save it and give it back to him. He did not like this. So he decided I wanted more paper airplanes. So he made one about every 5 minutes, turned around, and threw it at me. At first, I ignored it. After about 20 minutes, I couldn't ignore it anymore. I went up to my classroom teacher, but he did not feel this was a priority. So I was left to my own devices. I again tried to tell him that if he completed his work, I would still give him back his plane. Again, this did not stop him. About 10 minutes later, I found myself walking him down to the office. I will never forget seeing my professor in the hallway. She could see the frustration on my face. She asked the child to sit in a chair in the hallway and spoke with me privately. She posed a simple question: why do you think he is doing this? Of course, I thought it was because I took away his plane. But then I thought, what is going on in this child's life? After she calmed me down, I had an idea. I left my professor and went back up to the child. Instead of writing him up, I told him I wanted to have lunch with him. During lunch, he told me that his mother had left his family and he recently heard gunshots on his street. His house had a rat problem, and his father worked two jobs, not being around too often. Long story short, I discovered the child was not trying to anger me. He was crying out for help. Of course, my professor knew this. This story highlights why we are the strongest teaching candidates in the state. The environment the professor set and the collaboration between students is truly incredible. We are all in it together. We laugh together, struggle together, and now take our final steps together as we go our separate ways. But we will not be alone. The lessons we have learned from each other will stay with us throughout our careers. The following is the most important lesson I have learned in college. A young man is walking along the ocean and sees a beach on which thousands and thousands of starfish have washed ashore. Further along, he sees an old man walking slowly, bending down, and picking one starfish up after another and throwing it back into the ocean. "Why are you throwing starfish into the ocean?" the young man asks. "Because the sun is up and the tide is going out, and if I don't throw them back, they will die." "But old man, don't you realize there are miles and miles of beach and starfish all along it? You can't possibly save them all. What you will do will not even make a difference." The old man listened calmly, bent down to pick up another starfish, and threw it into the sea. "I made a difference to that one." My fellow graduates, even when it seems like the beach is littered with starfish, remember that when you take the time to reach down to help one, you'll never know the impact you will have. I would like to thank the professors and administrators in the School of Education who have shaped my time here at the college. And most importantly, I would like to thank my mother, father, and my entire family for their unwavering support over these past 4 years. Thank you, class of 2015, and congratulations.
Thank you, Kevin, for those inspiring words. I would like to now introduce Dr. Karen Prince, who will announce the awards for our graduates. I will be handing awards to the recipients on this side, so this is a picture opportunity for any parents who would like to capture this moment.
Good morning. Congratulations to all of our graduates. I'm so proud of all of you. It is with great pleasure that I will now announce the award recipients from our department. We have many outstanding and accomplished graduates, but the following individuals are particularly distinguished. As your name is called, please come to the stage to receive your certificate and your gift. To begin, I am delighted to announce our two recipients for the Elementary and Early Childhood Department Award. They are Brianna Falconer, a graduate in the Early Childhood Education Program. And Erica Joel, an elementary education graduate. Congratulations. Our next award is the Elementary and Early Childhood Department Chairperson's Award. Dr. Byers, our chairperson, will happily distribute the awards. Our two recipients of the Chairperson's Award are Maria Santomena from the Early Childhood Program, and Morgan Rumba an elementary education graduate. The Undergraduate Student Researcher Award is now presented to Jillian Manzo. Jillian. Our next award is the Dr. James Silver Memorial Award, presented in honor and memory of a beloved former department faculty member. This award is given to Kelsey Snedeker. Now we will recognize Courtney McGovern. Courtney is the recipient of the Florence Foster Award given by the Kenyan chapter of the National Association for the Education of Young Children. Courtney. The next award is the Jeanette Cutter Hodge Volunteer Service Award. Kevin Mount is the recipient of this award. I will now announce the Dr. Anthony Conti Kappa Delta Pi Scholarship Award. Dr. Conti, would you please join me at the podium? The award recipient is April Bullock. April is in the five-year program for the education of the deaf and hard of hearing and will receive her certification in elementary education also. We are delighted to have April here at our ceremony, and we are all very proud of her. Our final award is to be presented to a graduate of our Masters of Arts in Teaching program. The award is the Graduate Student Researcher Award, and I am very honored to welcome a most special guest to assist in the presentation of this award. Would Lance Corporal Tyler Ware please join me at the podium? Corporal Ware. Corporal Ware will present the award to his sister, the recipient of the award, Rebecca Ware.
Thank you.
And we all thank Corporal Ware for his service to our country. Oh my God, dear God, dear God, dear God. We are now awarding the Social Justice Advocacy Award. The recipient of this award is Lana Rahal. Let's give all of our award recipients a round of applause. Now I have the great pleasure of introducing to you Dr. Jody Eberle, who will announce the graduate student degree recipients in early childhood education. Dr. Eberle will also explain the procedure for diploma distribution. Dr. Eberle.
Congratulations to everyone. I'm going to begin by explaining our protocol for how we will proceed for the rest of the program. When your row is directed to stand, everybody from that program should stand and proceed as directed toward the stage. When your name is called, please come forward to receive your degree. Then please return to your row and remain standing until everyone in your row has received his or her degree. Members of the audience, please hold all applause until the entire row has received their degree. Once the applause is received for your row, graduates, you may sit down. We'll continue in this fashion until everyone has received his or her degree. So it is my pleasure to read to you the names of those receiving the Master of Arts in Teaching and Early Childhood Education. Please stand. Taryn Deal, Elizabeth Bagot. Congratulations. Thank you. Laurie Haven DeAnglis. Congratulations. Elizabeth M. Downs. Laurie Zimmerman Orsic.
So good to see you. Thank you. You're so great. Thank you.
Carol Ann Tomasi is not able to be with us. Jessica M. Verga.
Congratulations. I owe you the letter. I'll get it today. Promise, promise.
Congratulations. Stacy K. Weatherby.
Congratulations.
Jasmine S. Wheeler.
Congratulations.
And Daphne May Whitney. You may be seated. Thank you. It's now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Stuart Carroll, who will announce the Elementary Masters of Art in Teaching degree candidates.
If the Elementary Master of Arts in Teaching degree candidates could rise and approach the podium. Right. Eva Marie Genova. Ginger L. Hall. Amanda Happ Kelly. Sarah A. Markman. Katie Allison Miller. Heather Lynn Phillips. Vasundhara Srivatsava. Allison Marie Stewart. Had to happen. Rebecca L. Weir. Michelle Catherine Wallstromer. Aaron M. Yago. Okay, yeah, the applause can start. Please be seated. And I would like to introduce Dr. Tabitha DeLangelo, the coordinator of the Urban Ed Program, who will award the master's degree in urban education.
All right, so will my 5-year urban education majors rise? I'm so nervous for you guys, sorry. All right, so these folks have been here for 5 years and they're completing their master's and dual certifications, and I'm doing this because I'm not ready to let go of them, but here we go. Jessica Nicole Didyoung. Desiree Prima Gans. Erica Ann Paolucci.
Of course.
Erica Sade Roberts. Erica Nicole Rolek. Megan Lynn Steinberg. Amanda Lynn Torres. Daria Wells. Maria Therese Zulo. And I just want to acknowledge Jennifer Lambert, who couldn't be here today. And now I'd like to introduce Dr. Blythe Heinitz, who will start presenting the undergraduate degrees in early childhood education.
Thank you. Before we get to that, will the undergraduate and graduate members of the Honor Society of Phi Kappa Phi please rise in place? On behalf of the faculty, I congratulate you on your attainment of the highest academic honor a School of Education student can achieve, membership in the Honor Society of Phi Kappa Phi. Let's give them a big round of applause. Please be seated. Will the early childhood graduates please rise and come forward as your name is called? Carrie Ann Anneker, magna cum laude. Stephanie Baska, magna cum laude. Angelica M. Canzano, Felicia R. Clark, Brianna Stephanie Falconer, magna cum laude and recipient of the Elementary and Early Childhood Department Award. Kathleen Deidre Figueroa, Leah Nicole Hopkins, cum laude. Danielle Jessica Kinney. Jillian Lee Manzo, summa cum laude, and recipient of the Undergraduate Student Researcher Award. Courtney McGovern, magna cum laude, recipient of the Florence Foster Award, Kenyon Chapter of the New Jersey Association for the Education of Young Children. Allison Eileen McLean, cum laude. Christina Marie Paraday. Lana Rahal, summa cum laude, Social Justice Advocacy Award. Shonda S. Samuel. Maria Kelly Santomena, summa cum laude, Elementary and Early Childhood Department Chairpersons Award. Michelle Sarah Seelenfreud, cum laude. Emily Elizabeth Selner. Jennifer Lee Sharrow, cum laude. Congratulations to all the early childhood graduates. Give them a round of applause. Please be seated. I would like to introduce Dr. Anthony Conti, who will read the names of the elementary graduates.
Thank you, Dr. Heinitz. Good morning, and congratulations again to all of our graduates. Before we begin with the issuing of the diplomas, will the undergraduate and graduate members of the Honor Society of Kappa Delta Pi please rise in place? On behalf of the faculty, I congratulate you on your scholarship and service as a member of the Kappa Delta Pi International Honor Society in Education. Round of applause, please. Elementary education graduates, as your name is called, please come forward and proceed according to the directions given by Dr. Eberle and by Dr. Heinitz. Please remain standing when you return to your seat until your row is directed to be seated. Aileen Augusto. Thank you. Danielle Maria Bamundo. Amanda Banis. Congratulations. Sure. Brittany A. Burris. Melanie Jean Byrne. Congratulations. Melanie Jean Byrne is also cum laude. Tatiana Sue Campos. Shannon Helen Cassidy, cum laude. Congratulations. Brianna Rose Charles. Congratulations. Samantha R. Clark. Congratulations. Caitlin Marie Clear. Joseph Wesley Cole IV, magna cum laude. Congratulations, Joe.
Thank you.
Good. Rebecca Shepherd Kovitz. Deanna Marie DiCongelio, cum laude. Jamie A. DeMarco, cum laude. Stephanie Rose Diano. Paige Danielle Ennis. Nicole Ann Florio. Sarah Freeman. Nicole Michelle Galgano, cum laude. Congratulations. Hannah Sue Gallagher, magna cum laude. J.D. Ray Gambatisi. Catherine Gauze, magna cum laude. Lori C. Genovese, cum laude. Congratulations. Julia Giordano, magna cum laude. Congratulations.
Thank you.
A round of applause, please, for the row. Will the next row please rise? Lindsay Hope Gottfried. Linda Gu. Corey M. Harkins. Hi. Shannon Alexandra Hart, cum laude. Carlin Jane Hubert, cum laude. Thank you. Erica Lynn Joel, summa cum laude. Erica is also the recipient of the Elementary and Early Childhood Department Award. Congratulations. Good girl. Kathleen Ellen Johnston. Nicole Carady Jones, magna cum laude.
Thank you so much for everything.
James C. Kennedy. Congratulations. Amanda Elizabeth Kraus. Congratulations. Veronica Kraviak, cum laude. Alex Patrick Legay, magna cum laude. Congratulations. Jennifer Laspina, magna cum laude. Kristen Nicole Lapari. Andrea Lursky. Congratulations. Jessica M. Mannion, summa cum laude. Congratulations. Paige Francis Matt. Congratulations. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Very nice. Justin Mizuko, magna cum laude. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Carolyn Rose Middleton. Congratulations. Kevin James Mount, magna cum laude. Kevin is also the recipient of the Jeanette Cutter Hodge Volunteer Service Award. Congratulations. Jessica Irene Mustakas. Maureen Teresa Nealon. Magna cum laude. Congratulations. Hillary Hannah Nielsen, cum laude.
No.
Christine Ann Neville. Yona O. Violet Ortega. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Gina Nicole Ortolano, magna cum laude. A round of applause, please. Will the next row please rise? Brooke Avery Pasiak. Is that right? Thank you. Josie G. Perez. Jessica Elizabeth Pereira, magna cum laude. Kristen Pizzolo. Jillian Barbara Raleigh, magna cum laude. Congratulations.
Very nice. Good girl.
Allison Lee Rank, cum laude. Heather Nicole Roquette. Melissa Catherine Reedy. Janine Eugene Rinaldi, summa cum laude. Congratulations.
Very nice.
Thank you.
Christina Rodriguez. Alicia Mary Rolano, magna cum laude.
Congratulations. Good girl.
Morgan Kelly Rumba, magna cum laude. Morgan is also the recipient of the Elementary and Early Childhood Department Chairperson's Award. Ashley Nicole Rosman, summa cum laude.
Congratulations.
Chloe Ray Salzman.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Okay.
Chelsea Lynn Sandmeyer, cum laude.
Congratulations.
Tina Marie Scataro. Kathleen May Smith, magna cum laude. Dana Lynn Smith.
Congratulations.
Thank you, Dr.
Kelsey Lynn Snedeker, magna cum laude. Kelsey is also the recipient of the Dr. James Silver Memorial Award.
Congratulations.
Joy A. Spriggs.
No.
Caitlin Taylor Springsteen. Melanie Strollo, summa cum laude.
Congratulations.
Jennifer Ann Thorpe, magna cum laude.
Congratulations.
Jennifer Lauren Tobias, magna cum laude.
Congratulations.
Geneva Bess Torsilleri, summa cum laude. Susan Ashley Van Dyne, cum laude.
Congratulations. Very nice.
Thank you.
Gabriella Velasquez. A round of applause, please, for the row. Will the final row please rise? Alyssa. Alyssa Marie Velasquez.
Congratulations.
Alexandra Joy Wasserstein.
Congratulations. Very nice.
Monica Brooke Watson, magna cum laude. Sarah Helen Westfall, magna cum laude. Congratulations. Janine Catherine Young, cum laude. Congratulations. Joanna Michelle Juhas, magna cum laude. Shanna Margaret Zimmer. Kayleen A. Zuchek. Christina Rodriguez. Congratulations. Susan Renna. Congratulations. Congratulations to the elementary education graduates, class of 2015.
This has been awesome. I would just like to say a few more words. For those of you who are not in attendance yesterday evening, it is possible that your tassels are still on the wrong side. So although your degrees were conferred last night, if your tassel is on the right, please now take that moment to turn it to the left side of your mortarboard. I would like to thank everyone for attending. This has been a wonderful celebration of your achievements. And I would like to congratulate the Department of Elementary and Early Childhood's graduating class of 2015. And I would like to officially declare the ceremonies closed. Thank you, and go on and go forth and celebrate.